Hi, my name is Steve Sloan and I work for Accenture. I'll be talking about the different ways that we can make our programs run faster and use less space. Got 20 of them, and my email address is at the end. If you can think of any others, please reach out to me. And also, if you have any questions or you want some more information, please feel free to reach out to me. I'm a graduate of Brandeis University. I have master's degrees from Northern Illinois and Stern Business School. And I have a certificate of financial analysis from Stevens Institute. I'm a data science senior principal at Accenture, and I lead multifunctional projects there on a cross-industry basis using data science and artificial intelligence. I've presented at a number of SAS events, over 20 regional and global forums, and I've been published in professional journals. And I really appreciate being able to work with the nice people at SAS Institute, who are always very helpful and cooperative. In fact, on some of my papers, we've collaborated together. Now, what we're looking at here is that it can take a long time for our programs to run. And that's inconvenient, it can frustrate our users, it can retard our development. Also, the data being used by the programs can occupy a lot of space, and that can make them take even longer to run. First, because they're crunching through more space, and also because sometimes you run out of space and you have to start over. So anything we can do to save time and space will make our lives easier and enable us to serve our clients better. Now, we're often in a hurry. It's not like we're starting from a blank slate where we use all the traditional methods of structured programming and being careful. Sometimes we've got someone else's code and they say, can you just make a simple change to it? Which is never as simple as they say, although we benefit in reverse. Sometimes things that look complicated can tend to be simple, but I want to focus more on the other side. We also run into issues where we have very tight deadlines, so we don't always have a lot of time to really improve the program. We just want to get it to run. Now, there's four different, I've classified these efficiency programs in four different ways. One thing we can do is we can reduce the observations and variables, that's the rows and columns. We can reduce the number of times that the data is processed. We can look at sorting efficiencies to make it sort faster. A lot of times those proc sorts take a very long time if we're not careful. And we can also reduce the size of the variables. A lot of times we can squeeze more variables into our existing storage facility. We don't have to ask for new storage facilities. We don't have to run things in pieces if we can reduce their size. So to reduce the number of observations and variables, there are a few things we can do. We can use drop, keep, drop equals, keep equals, to make sure that only the needed variables are used. Drop and keep are commands you can use in your program. You don't want to use both because it'll keep everything that you don't drop, it'll drop everything that you don't keep. What I try to do, again, to make the programs easier to read is whichever list is shorter, that's what the one I'll use. If I'm keeping more than dropping, I'll use a drop and vice versa. Now, drop equals and keep equals, you can put right in your data set statements, in your data statement and in your set statements, your out equals statements. And there you can really mix and match. You can have a drop equals to bring things into your data set. And then you can put that on your set statement or a keep equals. And then when you're leaving the data step on your data statement, there are some variables you might have needed for your calculations, but you won't need on the output. You can use the drop equals or keep equals. You can use the subsetting if or the where statements. Make sure that only needed observations are used. And again, you can use where equals and drop equals, keep equals on the output data from your procs. One thing I do a lot is on the proc summary, I almost always drop the underscore type underscore, and quite often the underscore freak underscore. And these can be very helpful, so it saves you the trouble of going back in and running another data step to do your drop or your keep. Especially on a proc sort, again, you can reduce the amount of space you need and time right up front while you using a drop equals or keep equals. And then finally, you can use the underscore null underscore, the data null. If you don't need an output data set, that can be useful if you're just setting up macro variables for future use, simput, things like that. And just use the data null and you're not taking up any space with a SAS data set. Now, you can reduce the number of times that the data is processed. And where you would do that is you can use the rename equals in the set or the merge statements. Again, sometimes you're merging data sets or you're setting data sets in a concatenation format. And when you're doing that, you often have this, you often have variables that mean exactly the same thing, but they have different names. Now, what I used to do before I realized I could just rename in the set or the merge was go through another, create another data step, create a copy or take the existing data and rename the variable there and perhaps drop the old value. But you can do it right in your set or your merge. So if you're merging by AB and it's AC in your other data set, you can use the rename right after the data set in your set or your merge statement. You can use the proc format with the control in, or use if then else or case constructs. And this can be very valuable because now you're not having to go through a merge, especially the proc format. The control in is very useful on the proc format because you're defining a format and then you can use the put statement. So you don't have to do a sort, you don't have to do a merge. You can just do the put statement right in your data step. That'll save you quite a bit of time. Again, and the if then else or the case constructs, you can just use to manipulate the data so you don't have to reprocess it through through multiple data steps. Proc append instead of set, you can use to concatenate the SAS data sets. And then it's only processing the one being appended. It's not processing the one you've identified as the base data set. So if you have a data set with 20,000 observations and you want to append 2,000 observations to it, and they have the same data, does it have the same variable names, or you've done your rename equals? At that point, if you use the set, then you're processing 22,000 observations. But if you use the proc append, you're only processing the 2,000 that are in the smaller data set. You can use the class statements with proc summary or proc means with unsorted data. And again, I want to alert you here. If the data is already sorted, then it's faster to use the by statement with the proc summary or the proc means because it's only going to process the individual segments identified by the by statement. It's only going to process those subsets. On the other hand, if the data is not sorted, then you can use the class statement and you won't have to sort it. So the hierarchy here is the fastest is the proc summary or the proc means with a by statement for previously sorted data. The proc summary or the proc means with a class statement for unsorted data and sorting, and then using the summary or means is the slowest with the by statement. And you can take the most, if you're running if then else or case constructs, put the most commonly occurring situations first, because what will happen is once it finds it, then it'll stop going through that decision tree. So if you put the most commonly occurring situations first, it's only going to go through the first condition on your if then else or your case construct. Now there's some sorting efficiencies that are very helpful. You can use the tag sort with the large data sets with proc sort, and it'll use less space, but it might take longer. What will happen with the tag sort is it'll take the variables that you're sorting by, and it'll temporarily separate them and put pointers back. And so it'll take those variables and it'll just sort a small data set containing only those variables. So it'll use a lot less space because it won't be pulling your entire data set into the buffer. However, it could take longer. It depends on how big your data set is and how much time you're saving, because you are going after the data twice. First, you're going after the data to pull your bivariables, and then you're going back and getting the data. However, the efficiency you gain from sorting a much smaller number of variables will, in many cases, more than make up for the fact that you're going after it twice. Something I've got on my to-do list for the future is to see if I can get more specific and actually get an algorithm for when to use tag sort and when tag sort will make it take longer. But if your main constraint is space, tag sort will definitely save you space. Now, you don't have to run a proc sort to get a sorted data set. Your data set may already be sorted. And if you know that it's sorted, then you can use the by statements with your other procs. As you remember in the previous slide, I talked about using the by statements with the class and the means. There you're saving the trouble of the sort, but you're getting the benefit of the fact that your proc is processing smaller subsets of the data instead of the entire data set all at once. And finally, there's a pre-sorted option in proc sort, and pre-sorted will tell you if the data set has been sorted. And so that's a short job. And if you're not sure, pre-sorted might add a little extra time if you know it's sorted, but it'll save you from some sorts. Now, you can also reduce the size of the variables. Reducing the size of the variables, there's a number of different ways to do it. You can use the length command to define the lengths of both character and numeric variables. What will happen quite often, you'll be bringing a data set in from Oracle or from an Excel spreadsheet or a CSV file. And what you'll find is that SAS will default to 255 characters. That will almost always be much more than what you need. So if you need to save space and you know what the maximum length is, use the length command and just define the length of the variable. Now, if a numeric variable is always an integer, you can use the table at the end of the deck to define the length. I'm going to go to that table now. On this table, you have the length in bytes and the maximum absolute value. So if you know that your variable is always an integer, and this is important because it doesn't always work if any of them aren't integers, then you can use that table to define the length. And because SAS will default to 8 bytes on a numeric variable. And as I mentioned earlier, you want to calculate the maximum length of character variables, especially those from Oracle or from Excel. Now, there are times when an integer numeric variable would be better off as a character variable. And again, looking at this chart, you can see that the smallest length for a numeric variable is 3 bytes. Now, if your numeric variable is only 2 bytes or is only 1 byte, then you'll save space as a character variable. And you can check and make sure that it's between -9 and 99. Remember, the minus sign takes up space as on a character variable. So even though you can go up to 99 on the positive side, you can only go to -9 on the negative side. And I find this quite useful. Quite often I'll be working with data that's basically yes, no, or 0, 1. So I only need 1 byte. And it comes in as 8 bytes. I can reduce it to 3 bytes if I keep it numeric, but I can reduce it to 1 byte if I switch it to a character variable. And then also, you can take your all integer character variables and switch them to numeric if they're longer than 3 bytes. And again, looking back at this chart for the numeric variables, you can see that you can get up into the millions or the billions as you start to get lengths and bytes of greater than 3. So for instance, on that example, if you have something that that goes up to a million, and it's a character variable, you're taking up 7 bytes. If it has commas, you're taking up 9. But it would only, as a numeric variable, it would only take up 4. So again, there are tests you can use. You can use the INT function, and you can test and see if they're all numeric. You can use the, if you want to check if they're all integer, you can use the INT function, which will truncate, and check and see if they come out the same after that truncation. And then once you know they're all integer, you can reduce the integer size, and also you can use the function to check for missing values if you're using an input function on the character variables. Now here's some other efficiencies that can be very valuable. You can use reuse equals yes, and basically that'll just reuse space in your system. Sometimes SAS will not reuse space that isn't needed anymore on your Windows or on your Unix boxes. And so reuse equals yes will free up more space for your program to use, so that after you've deleted files, you get some of that space back, or after you've reprocessed them. Now you can use compress equals yes or compress equals binary. Compress equals yes gets rid of leading and trailing blanks. Compress equals binary doesn't always respect the byte boundaries and just crunches the data all together. I've found gotten great reductions in space using compress equals binary. It could make the job run longer, however, because when you're using these compressions, SAS will decompress when it's processing. Again, that could be a future research to get an algorithm about testing specifically when compress equals yes or compress equals binary, when the compression, which saves space, will make the job run longer. Again, especially with data sets you're not going to use very much, you can compress them, and it really, really saves you a lot of space. Sometimes with compress equals binary, I've been able to cut my space usage by 90% or more. Now, when the program finishes, SAS deletes all of the work data sets, all the data sets with the work live name, the work.data sets. But you can use proc delete, and you can delete them when you no longer need them. And again, that frees up space, especially when combined with reuse equals yes. And when you're extracting from external databases like Oracle, do as much work as possible in the external database. If you do it through the connect and you work in the external database, then you're taking advantage of a lot of the efficiencies that are in Oracle or in Teradata. And you're doing a lot of work there based on the fact that it was stored in Oracle. You're taking advantage of the efficiencies. And so you're only bringing back to SAS the rows and columns that you need after the work is done. On the other hand, if you do with a live name, it brings everything into SAS and then works on it there. And so you've got the migration issue, you've got the time for the migration and also the time to work on it in SAS. Now, it could require more processing once it's in SAS because everything has a caveat. The one advantage of using the live name, doing it in SAS, is that you have your SAS functions available to you. If there are SAS functions that are not available in the external database, then you will need to at least work partially on it in SAS. Again, a good mix is to do as much as you can in the external database, bring the rest over to SAS, and then finish up with any SAS functions that you need. And a lot of this is a judgment call, and a lot of this is using your experience, knowing how much you can do in the external database versus how much you need for SAS functions. On all these things, there's always a caveat. Here's the chart that we showed about the length of the numeric variables. My contact information is stephen.b.sloan@accenture.com. Please feel free to reach out to me at any time. I'd be happy to review this. I'm always learning. I'm always getting good suggestions. So if you have tricks, techniques, tips for efficiency, please send them on. Perhaps I can incorporate them and give you credit the next time I give this presentation. Thank you very much for taking the time to attend.